Hello, hi everyone. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss the concept of nuclear reactor. To understand the concept of nuclear reactor, first you should know what do you mean by nuclear fission, control chain reaction and thermal neutrons. If you don't know or if you still have any doubts over these three concepts, click on the link given in the description. What do you mean by nuclear reactor? Nuclear reactor is a device in which control chain reaction takes place, releasing large amount of heat. Now let us go to the parts of nuclear reactor. Nuclear reactor mainly consists of moderator. These are called as moderators. This moderator is made up of water or graphite. Okay, these moderators are used to slow down the fast moving neutrons. Next part is fuel rods. These are called as fuel rods. These fuel rods are made up of fissionable materials like uranium-235, and these are sealed in aluminium cylinders. Okay, this moderator and fuel rods are combinedly placed in core. Next, this is called as coolant. Generally, liquid sodium or heavy water is used as coolant, and this coolant is used to remove the heat generated from the core. Okay, and these rods are called as control rods. Control rods are made up of boron or cadmium. These control rods are used to absorb the neutrons. Okay, this core and this coolant is covered by a shielding. This is called as shielding. By shielding called as radiation shielding. This radiation shielding is made up of thick massive concrete, and this is used to protect from radiations generated from the core. Along this radiation shielding, core, control rods, moderator and fuel rods, you have a steam generator, a turbine, a condenser and a generator. Now let us discuss the working of nuclear reactor. Okay, there will be somewhere near the nuclear reactor or inside the nuclear reactor, there will be a neutron source. From this neutron source, neutrons will come out. These neutrons enter into the core of nuclear reactor, and on their way they hit the uranium-235 nuclei, which is present in the fuel rod, and undergo nuclear fission reaction. Okay, now what happens? These neutrons, after hitting the uranium-235 nuclei, they undergo nuclear fission reaction and release three neutrons. These neutrons will come out with large velocity, such that their energy is equal to 2 mega electron volt. Now this velocity is so large that they skip the nuclear fission reaction. Now what happens? These three neutrons, when they move in the core, on their way they hit the moderator or graphite. That is, they hit the water molecules or graphite molecules. And what happens is they undergo elastic collision and give their energy to these moderators. Because of this elastic collision, what happens? Their energy will reduce from 2 mega electron volt to 0.02 electron volt. Means here you can see that there is a lot of reduction in energy because of elastic collision. So because of this reduction, what happens? Their velocity will be reduced. Means these three neutrons, which are emitted with large velocity after undergoing elastic collision, they reduce their velocity to very low value. Okay, these slow moving neutrons are called as thermal neutrons. Okay, now these three thermal neutrons, again they move in the core of nuclear reactor and hit with three more uranium-235 nuclei. Okay, now what happens? One neutron entered into the core, underwent nuclear fission reaction, and three neutrons are released. These three neutrons again on their way will hit three more neutrons, three more uranium-235 nuclei, and release total nine neutrons. Now, if you nuclear fission reaction keeps on going, what happens? One neutron will become three neutrons. Three will again give you nine. Nine will again give you 27. And if this continues, what happens? This nuclear fission reaction cannot be stopped. That is, the fission reaction will be uncontrollable. Now, to control the nuclear fission reaction, what we will do is we will take the help of control rods. So, we will take the help of control rods. Now what happens is, so you know that one neutron after hitting the uranium-235 nuclei gave us three neutrons. Now by somehow, if you can absorb two neutrons from the released three neutrons, what will happen? One neutron after undergoing nuclear fission reaction will give you only one effective neutron. Okay, what does it mean? It means that one neutron after undergoing nuclear fission reaction will give you only one effective neutron. This can be done by what you call this control rods. Okay, now one neutron after undergoing nuclear fission giving out one neutron means one effective neutron means you are making sure that the value of reproduction factor K is equal to 1. Okay, so based upon this reproduction factor, what they'll do is they'll adjust the height of these control rods such that they make sure that the value of K is always equal to 1. To know more about reproduction factor, click on the link given in the description. Okay, now what happens? These control rods can be moved up and down based upon the value of K. Okay, and if these control rods are completely inserted into the core of nuclear reactor, what happens is the value of K will become far less than 1 and this nuclear fission reaction will be stopped. You know that during the process of a nuclear fission, a large amount of heat will be released and this heat will be absorbed by the moderators. So during long time or after some time, what happens? This entire core will become heated up. Now the coolant which surrounds the core will absorb this heat. They get heated up and enter into the steam generator. This steam generator consists of pipes and through which water will flow through these pipes. Now this water will absorb the heat generated from the steam generator or heat present in the steam generator. They absorb that heat, they get converted into vapor, that is gas. This gas will go inside the turbine, rotate the turbine, and by the process of electromagnetic induction, you'll get a current that is generated in the generator. Okay, these turbines, gas, after rotating the turbines, what happens is they enter into the condenser. Now, regarding this turbine and generator, there is one important point to note, that is, you have different ways of generating electricity. Those few ways are by using a hydroelectric power station and by using windmills, and this is nuclear reactor. Okay, so in all these three, that is hydroelectric power station, windmills and nuclear reactor, this turbine and generator will be common. Okay, now the only difference is the way we rotate turbines. In the case of hydroelectric power stations, it is the water that is collected at a large height. It is the water that is collected at the large height that rotates the turbines. Okay, this water will be allowed to fall from a large height over the turbines, because of which what happens, turbines will rotate. And because of this rotation of turbines and by the concept of electromagnetic induction, power will be generated. Now if you go to the concept of windmills, it is the wind that rotates the turbines and finally you'll get a current in the generator. Okay, now what did we discuss? We discussed that the steam that is generated in the steam generator rotates the turbine and enter into the condenser. This steam after entering into the condenser, it gets converted into water and then again goes back into the steam generator. Okay, now let us see about coolant. This coolant, after absorbing heat from the from the core, they enter into the steam generator, transmit their heat to the water, and it gets cooled up and again goes into the core with less amount of heat. Okay, this process will continue. Now let us see the uses of nuclear reactor. This nuclear reactor is used to generate electric power. Next, these are used to produce fissionable materials like plutonium-235 and other fissionable materials. And these produced fissionable materials are used in the field of medicine industry.
If you feel that this video is useful, kindly share to your friends. If you have any doubts or suggestions, you can comment me in the comment section. Do like and subscribe, because your single like and comment will encourage me for making better videos. Thank you.